Welcome to Biology Easy Classes Online. In previous video, we study the mechanism of transcription in prokaryotes, and in this video, we study about the mechanism of transcription in eukaryotes and also do the comparative study about both the mechanism. So let's start. In eukaryotes, there are three RNA polymerase, namely RNA polymerase 1, 2 and 3, responsible for transcribing different RNA. But if we see in prokaryote that we studied in earlier video, a single RNA polymerase is responsible for transcribing all the RNA. RNA polymerase 1 transcribe rRNA, that is ribosomal RNA. RNA polymerase 2 responsible for transcribing mRNA and hnRNA, that is messenger RNA and heterogeneous RNA. And RNA polymerase 3 is responsible for transcribing tRNA, that is transfer RNA. So let's start the steps. So first step is your initiation. In initiation, there are a promoter region and a terminator region. So initiation starts at the promoter region. If there is a sequence called Tata box is present, then the initiation gets start. So what is Tata box? Tata box is nothing. It is only a sequence of nucleotide, that is thymine, adenine, thymine and adenine. And not only this Tata box is sufficient to initiate the process, but also the 6 transcriptional factors are also needed to initiate the step. And in prokaryote, what will happen? A sigma factor is responsible to initiate the process, but here no sigma factor is needed. Here is a complex process done. Second step is your elongation. In elongation, now it is same. In elongation, the RNA polymerase continues to unwind the DNA double helix and adds the nucleotide continuously and forming a RNA. So third step is your termination. In eukaryote, termination of transcription occurs by different processes depending upon the exact polymerase utilized. So whenever the polymerase gets utilized, the termination gets occurred. So this is about the 3 points, so that is initiation, elongation and termination. So the transcription in eukaryote does not end and only at termination. Now the RNA formed here after termination undergoes post-transcriptional modification. So the what is post-transcriptional modification? That after transcription, what are the modification occur in RNA to become mature? To become mature for translation. Before going into the topic post transcriptional modification, let's discuss about introns and exons. What are that? Introns and exons. Introns are non-coding regions of RNA that do not code for any protein. Got it? And exons are coding regions of RNA that code for specific proteins. So this is our transcribed RNA. Got it? It have both the regions, that are exons, introns. Exons, introns. Subsequently, consecutively, it have exons and introns. Got it? Now we start about post-transcriptional modification. Post-transcriptional modification. So first step in post-transcriptional modification is your splicing. What is splicing? We know there are 2 regions, exons, introns. Exons, introns. Got it? Now splicing is the removal of non-coding regions and the addition of only coding regions. That is removal of introns and addition of exons. Got it? So what happened? The introns get spliced. And what happened? Only exons gets added. So what is this? Introns gets spliced and only exons get attached. So this is called splicing, that is removal of introns, removal of non-coding regions, only addition of coding regions. So second step is your capping. Before going into the capping, let's deal with some very basic terms. This is a prokaryotic cell that do not have any membrane bound organelle, and this is a eukaryotic cell that have membrane bound organelle and also have well defined nucleus. So we know fact that transcription occur in nucleus. Got it? And translation, that is formation of protein, occurs in cytoplasm. Got it? So if nucleus and cytoplasm are not distinguished in prokaryotic cells, so what will happen? The transcription and translation occurs in same compartment, so there is no compartmentalization in prokaryotic cells. While in eukaryotic cells, transcription occurs in nucleus and translation occurs in cytoplasm. So see, this is a cell, this is a nucleus. When a RNA gets transcribed from DNA, then what will happen? This RNA comes out to the nucleus through the nuclear pore in the cytoplasm and attaches to the ribosomes and gets synthesized and synthesize the protein, that is translation, and start the process of translation. But remember, the cytoplasm have enzymes called nucleases. Got it? So enzymes, nucleases, what they done? They are capable of digesting the nuclear material, that is genetic material, DNA or RNA. They can digest them or they can denature them. So if our RNA comes in the cytoplasm, then the nucleases gets denatured our RNA. So from denaturing of our RNA from nucleases, the capping, that is our second step, and tailing, that is our third steps, is done. So why capping and tailing, second and third step, is done? To prevent our RNA to get denatured by the enzymes called nucleases present in the cytoplasm. So what is capping? So this is our mRNA. Got it? So what is this? This is our mRNA and this is a 5 prime end and this is our 3 prime end. At 5 prime end, there is an addition of methyl guanosine triphosphate. And this is called capping. In 5 prime end, there is addition of methyl guanosine triphosphate so that it prevents the attack of nucleases. And third step is your tailing. In tailing, 200 to 300 adenylate residue. Adenylate residue means the adenine that are remained. That is adenosine. Okay. So adenine that are residue, that are remain, gets attached to the 3 prime end. This is our mRNA. This is 3 prime end. There are many adenine attached. This is called adenylated. So tailing is happened by the 200 to 300 adenylated residue. So these are the three steps. That is, first we study splicing, second capping, and third is your tailing. These are post-transcriptional changes or modification that occur in eukaryotic. And in prokaryote, we know there is no compartmentalization, that is no nucleus, so the transcription and translation occur in same compartment. So in splicing, what will happen? Introns gets removed, that is non-coding portion gets removed, and coding portion, that is exons, get attached. So the mRNA, RNA have only coded regions. So listen, this is firstly our first transcribed RNA that have both exon introns, that is both coding and non-coding regions, are called hnRNA. That is heterogeneous RNA. Heterogeneous means different. So that it has different regions, that is exons, and introns. After splicing, that is after removal of non-coding regions, that is introns, it only have coding regions. Now this is our mature RNA. Got it? So what is hnRNA and mRNA? And the capping and tailing are done. Why they are done? In order to prevent the RNA from the attack of nucleases, so that it cannot get denatured. So let us summarize the whole topic in few minutes. So we see RNA polymerase, different RNA polymerase, that is RNA polymerase 1 for rRNA, 2 for transcribing mRNA, hnRNA, and 3 for tRNA. Then we see 3 steps, that is first initiation, that is initiated by Tata box sequence, and 6 transcriptional factor, elongation, that is RNA polymerase unwinds the DNA helix and continue the process of elongation, and termination, that means that RNA polymerase when gets utilized, then the RNA gets extracted and the transcription gets stopped. And after the transcription gets completed, our RNA that is being formed to become mature, it gets into post transcriptional modification. And we see the 3 post transcriptional modification, that is splicing, capping, and tailing. In splicing, we see there is a removal of non-coding sequence, that is introns, and addition of coding sequence, that is exons. So this is our, so before splicing, our RNA is called hnRNA, that means it has both sequence, introns as well as exons. And after splicing, there is only addition of coding parts, that is exons. So now it gets mature and it is called a messenger RNA. Second and third step, that is capping and tailing, are done in order to prevent our RNA from the attack of nucleases. So what are nucleases? Nucleases, these are the enzymes that can digest or degrade the nuclear material, that is genetic material, DNA or RNA. Got it? So capping is done by the methyl guanosine triphosphate at 5 prime end, and tailing is done by 200 to 300 adenylate residue, that is adenine addition, so many adenine addition at 3 prime end. See here, addition of adenine at 3 prime end. So this is all about the mechanism of transcription in eukaryotes. So thank you for watching this video, and comment me your doubts if you have.